press on to me like he was putting his body under subjection. Talk to me, somebody. That sounded to me like Jesus was bringing his body, my God, in right standing with the word. Because Jesus was 100% God and 100% a man. The humanity of Jesus get hungry. The divinity of Jesus never get hungry. So Jesus said, I got a balance to the humanity and divinity, because I know what I came to do. I got to keep my body under subjection, because demons will not come out of folks when your flesh is alive. Talk to me, somebody. The anointed will not rest on you when your flesh is alive. So now my flesh is one of the serious enemies. There's no enemy like the enemy that is in me. Talk to me, somebody. I know you're talking about some of y'all say, what am I saying? Pastor, what you talking about? I thought the devil was the enemy. Let me tell you something. Satan can't use you except you agree. Talk to me, somebody. He can't come in the house that he is not invited. Talk to me, somebody. Glory be to God. So now Jesus knows if he's going to get this ministry to the people of God, he got to keep his body under subjection. I know I'm hungry, but right about now, you ain't eating. You're not going to eat, because I need spiritual power, spiritual insight. I need God to do something in my life. Glory be to God. I stand, oh my God. I die being dry. Oh God, I'm ready to move with substance. I'm ready to move with power. I'm ready to operate. Oh God, to operate with the apostolic authority. And so Jesus, bring his body under subjection. And since of God, when you're bringing your body under subjection, it's not an easy thing, because there's a consistent fight. You know, what I'm talking about. Paul said, the things that I do not, that do I do. I don't like what I do, but I can't help it. Oh, mercy. Hallelujah. I can't help it. I can't help it. I know what I need to be doing, but that, oh God, the way the information I got it, but how to apply it, I can't do it. And so many times, we are preparing ourselves for a move of God. Amen. And fasting and praying, the first thing happened, your headache started. You got a headache. I didn't have a headache for God for the past 6 months. And the minute I decided that I need to go on a fast, here comes your headache. Oh God, I was going through mourning with not eating. And the minute I said that I'm on a fast, oh God, I feel hungry. I don't know where it comes from. I start smelling all kinds of food. Talk to me, somebody. I'm trying to bring my body under subjection, but I smell all kinds of food. It's like my nose start to operate with spiritual discernment. I start to smell and don't even know where it's coming from. Come on, somebody. It's only the devil trying to distract you, because he knows if you ever go on a fast and pray, glory be to God, if you ever get into the presence of God, if you ever, come on, somebody, get in the place where God begin to walk with you, you're going to have some problems. Some problems with you. Oh God. And so Jesus gave them authority. And he says, you are sending you out. I'm sending you out to a dying world. I'm sending you out like a sheep amongst a bunch of wolves. Jesus. I'll say to you, Lord, a sheep is a humble lamb, but when you look at the wolf, oh God, he'll cut you to pieces if you let them do it. That's why he said, I can't send you out except I give you power. Come on, somebody. Acts 1:8. Jesus said, that the Holy Ghost come upon you, you shall have power. Come on, somebody. We can't have no God. We are a church. We ought to have some power. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It's about time for us to know our position in Christ. Come on, somebody. Stop allowing the devil to walk on you and to move you and to keep you bound. I'm talking to somebody. You allow the devil to roll you from this end to that end, and he will stop until you step in power. I say in the name of Jesus, oh God, in the name of Jesus, I'm getting ready to fight back. I'm fighting back. Because the Bible said, from the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. I'm telling you, there's a violence going on. But look here, but the world, take it by force. Come on, somebody. You got power. You can do it. You can go over the highway and byway and compel them to come. You can go and loose that woman. And all kinds of addiction, you can set it free, because God has given you apostolic authority in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. High five to people and say, I'm going to step on in the apostolic anointing. And the apostolic anointed. Come on, somebody. I know I got power. I got power. Now you got power. You need to start speaking to some things that you have no business being in your life. Gonna talk to you. Oh God, a lot of stuff that is going on in your life. It's supposed to be going on. Because you are a child of God. I'm not talking about persecution for righteousness' sake, but I'm talking about those other Lord, extra Lord, that you have in the carry. You better delete them and tell the devil, I'm not carrying. All the joy ride is over. It's over. Come on, somebody. You can get away here. Stop. This is where a bus stop. You're coming out. You're coming off. You're coming off. Because I got to go higher in the Lord. I got to go higher in my God. Though he slay me, oh God. But yeah, I trust him. When it don't look good, I trust him. When I go to him, I trust him. Somebody say, I trust him. I trust him. And he gave the power 2 by 2. 2 by 2. Why? Why? The Bible says one can put 1,000 to flight, but 2, 10,000. Come on, somebody. You got some power when you walk with someone that walking with Jesus. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It's time for the church to arise and shine and be the deacon of light. Come on, somebody. The only way the world Jesus. Thank God. And then they look at you and they say, you know what? Something is different about you. Every time you step in, I feel a peace that I cannot explain. Hallelujah. Because a child of God have anointed. When you come in a room, you lift the room. When you go into dark places, you bring light in the dark places. When you go among sick folks, the sick folks ought to get healed because of that anointed that is on your life. Come on, somebody. Are you anointed? Are you anointed? I want you to tell yourself, say, self, I'm going to keep you under subjection. Oh, God. Flesh, you're going to keep you under subjection. I know you want to do those things that everybody else doing. But, oh, God, the Bible said that we are a peculiar set of people. You are different. You are not supposed to be like the world. The world is supposed to be like you. Stop letting the world try to influence you when you need to influence the world. Talk to me, somebody. Hallelujah. Your mission is to win them for God, not them for you. Them to win you to the devil. Come on, somebody. Some conversation, some corrupt communication, I gotta delete it. Talk to me, somebody. The word of Hebrew said that we gotta cease from corrupt communication. Come on, somebody. I know you wanna talk about somebody, but I'm too busy. Because of the persecution of Jesus Christ, because of the persecution of the gospel, he said, I'm not going to speak no more. But Jeremiah said, you know what? Something in me, even when I want to draw my peace, something in me. And Jeremiah could not describe it. And the only close thing he could come to it, he says, like fire burning in my bones. I don't feel it in my flesh. I feel it in my bones. I feel it in my bones. And I gotta open my mouth and testify about the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me. You don't know why the Lord brought me out. You don't know how he lift me up out of the miry clay and set my feet. You say, Pastor, you're crazy. Pastor, don't take all of that. You better shut your mouth. How dare you tell me